गुरुर् ब्रह्मा गुरुर् विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वर गुरुर् साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। ओम भवताप प्रणाशिन्ने आनंद घनमूर्तये ज्ञान भक्ति प्रदायिन्ने मातस्तुभ्यं नमो नमः। जय मां जय मां जय मां जय मां एवरीबॉडी जय मां। क्वेश्चन, somebody has asked, what is the concept of spiritual vibrations? Concept. Okay. See, all of us are basically spiritual beings that everybody is aware of, but we are covered with a lot of overcoats, avarans of Maya. Thick, heavy, dense. What happens is from your childhood, the moment you are born and everything, there are vibrations all around you. You are full of vibrations. The kind of vibrations you receive are good, bad and ugly. So it depends on what kind of vibrations you are receiving all the time and you are growing up. During your upbringing period, you might be, you know, in the company of people who are gross and dense and all that. Your vibrations will be very dense because you're not exposed to finer things. It could be. Then it all depends on what kind of upbringing you have, what kind of sanskar you get from your family, friends, your environment, the kind of people you meet. You go for parties, you go for discos. You go to, you know, different places, it gets denser and denser and denser. Everything is dense because yahan jo hum log hai, jo dharti pe hum log hai, vibrations, it's Kaliyug. Vibrations are very, very dense. Black clouds, you know. We have to pierce that and come to ourselves, right? It's work. It's a lot of work. So the vibrations are very dense around us. So we also become dense. Now, when you enter spirituality and you do a lot of sadhana, again, the same thing. Go on doing, your vibrations will become finer and finer and finer and purer. Okay, because har vakt hum log harinam kar rahe hain. We are taking the name of the Lord, we are doing jap dhyan, whatever we are doing, whatever path you are following will make your vibrations purer, finer, lighter, not dense. It will break the denseness that you have accumulated during your life. So the vibrations, the spiritual vibrations are always very fine, very refined. So I'll give you an example. During the beginning stages of my sadhana, you know, I was into sadhana and I had attended one satsang. There was one Mahatma sitting on my right and there was a householder sitting on my left. Now I was in dhyan, you know, my eyes were shut and all that, and I was concentrating on the kirtan bhajan that was going on in the satsang. And I noticed you have to be very observant about everything. Awareness honi chahiye all the time. The vibrations that I received from my right through the Mahatma was so light, I could not even feel him. I could not feel that there was somebody sitting on my right. It was like just breeze. It was so light and beautiful. My left side was burning, actually burning. My arm was hot. And I said, why am I feeling the heat on my left and I'm not feeling anything on the right? It's so light and beautiful, you know. And on my left, it was heavy, dense, warm, like heat. And I immediately realized that the person who was on my left was carrying such heavy vibrations that it was affecting me. So this is possible. This is what is happening all the time. And if we are in the company of those kind of people all the time, your vibrations will also be very dense and heavy. Kabhi kabhi wo vibrations hume lagte hain when you are into sadhana. If a person comes near you who's very heavy and dense and not doing any kind of sadhana or doing anything and just enjoying life, you will feel the heaviness of his personality. That is vibration. is energy basically. And the more you go into sadhana, those vibrations, that energy becomes lighter and lighter and lighter. And so with that kind of a thing, your entire demeanor changes, your nature changes. You have more love and affection for people. You will have kindness, compassion. You will feel better about human beings around you, and you will want to help them all the time because your entire demeanor has changed because of you entering the spiritual path. So that helps others also. There was another incident I remember. I was in Bhimpur Ashram, and there was a Mahatma who came out of Swami Bhaskaranji's kutia. He came out of the room, and when I looked at him, his face was shining. It was glowing. It was like light on his face, you know. I didn't even know him. I didn't know who he was. And he just came in front of me, and he was looking at me, and I was looking at him. And I said, I didn't know him, but it just came out. And I said, my God, look at your face. You're full of light. Look at your face. It's shining. So you know what he tells me? I wasn't aware of it. He looks at my face and he says, look who's talking. What about you? I said, what about me? He says, you're telling me this? Look at your own face. There's so much light. I said, is it? I never realized. Hame khud nahi pata chalta hai. But people around us will notice. You'll start looking softer, better. Your face will have that softness, which maybe it didn't have once upon a time. Why? Because the vibrations are becoming purer and purer and purer and lighter and lighter and lighter. It's like breeze. Hawa mein ud sakte hain. Itna light ho jata hai. Vibration. So the spiritual vibrations are like that, and it touches everybody around you. So when you go close to anybody who has these spiritual vibrations, about what you call it, you will just be calm. Even if you are your mind is in a clutter and you're distressed, or you have a lot of stress or tension, you will suddenly go to a Mahatma, sit next to him, you just sit and look at him, all your questions go away, khatam ho jate hain. और उनका चेहरा देख के यू फील पीस, काम, सेरेनिटी. एंड यू विल से व्हाट हैपेंड, इट्स द वाइब्रेशन दैट हैज टच्ड यू. एंड इफ योर वाइब्रेशंस आर डेंस, समबडी कैन टेल यू हु इज स्पिरिचुअली हाई दैट योर वाइब्रेशंस आर हर्टिंग मी, बिकॉज इट्स ऑल अबाउट ईगो अगेन. ईगो बिकम्स सो हाई, वाइब्रेशंस बिकम सो डेंस दैट इट हर्ट्स यू. So when your vibrations are getting purer, you don't want to have company of people who are dense, gross, and who have those kind of vibrations. You want to stay away. You'll say, no, it doesn't suit me. Aur ek zamane mein kya hota hai? It doesn't matter, because you yourself are that heavy. That somebody else's heavy vibrations won't even bother you, because you are that. But as you go on getting purer and purer, you won't want to keep that company. You will want to be with people who are spiritually high. So that is the concept of spiritual vibrations. It improves your entire life. It improves your health. It improves everything. All your surroundings become better. Things happen just automatically. You think of something and it is happening. You don't have to make an effort, because you're going purer and purer. That's where we've come from. And we have come here into the Maya world, and we have developed all these avarans around us. Now the whole exercise is to break that again and go back. To remove those avarans. We are not the avarans. We are that refined, pure vibration. We are the spiritual vibration. But we are covered with so much stuff and so much muck, that we have to just remove the muck and you are there. So I hope this has answered your question. And please give me a feedback of how you feel. Do write to me. Thank you. Jai Ma. Om Bhavatapa Pradashinne Ananda Ghanamurtaye Jnana Bhakti Pradayinne Matastubhyam Namo Namaha. Jai Ma, Jai Ma. Please subscribe. If you think what I'm doing is what you like, please subscribe. Subscribe banta hai. Like bhi banta hai. Thank you. Jai Ma.